This is a crash course in glass. What do you need to know? What kind of variables to look like and what goes into specifying glass? The piece of glass, the outside, is called a pane of glass, and that's the singular material that's out there that can be different thicknesses, some different properties. We used to create glass, like, you know, way back on a big metal table that was called plate glass. You'd pour liquid glass, which is essentially just molten sand, onto this flat piece of metal. Then it wasn't perfectly flat, so you try and grind it flat, and you know it did okay, but not perfect. Then I'm not exactly sure when, but somebody came up with the technology, figure this out. Let's melt down a bunch of tin. We'll make a big tin pool, and then we'll pour our glass onto that tin pool. And the tin's very flat as opposed to metal. And so that's how most glass is made today. It's called float glass. You can get into very specific nuances of how flat and all those things, but a bit beyond what we're talking about today. So the main float glass is called annealed glass. That has some residual stress left in it, tensile on the outside. So when it breaks, you end up with big pieces of sharp glass. I'm sure someone's seen some glass that breaks and cut yourself. That's annealed glass. So the other thing you can do is heat strength or toughen. They're a little bit different, but toughened glass, you use a heat strengthening process and you cool it quickly. When you cool it quickly, it creates the reverse effect, a compressive strength on the outsides of the glass, outsides of the surfaces. So when that breaks, it breaks into these small little chunks that aren't as sharp. It'll shatter into, you know, a million pieces of little cubes of glass, but they're not sharp. They won't cut you as easily. You could probably cut yourself, but not as easily. Somewhere in between is heat strengthened. It uses a very similar process to heat to toughened, but doesn't quite have that same fracture ability, but gives you this toughness. So when you go through that heat treatment and toughening process, it also makes the glass a lot stronger. So if you imagine a rope, you're holding a rope loosely, it's got some flexibility this way. When you pull it tight, it stiffens up that way. That's what that heat strengthener toughening process does. So it creates a stronger piece of glass. So if you've got an application where somebody might break that glass and cut themselves, you go to a toughened so you don't have that cut issue. If you're just looking for the extra strength in like a canopy or skylight or a window where you want to get thinner glass but stronger, you go to the heat strengthened option. In addition to the individual parts of glass, you can also make super glass, which is laminated together. So you can take two of those pieces of glass, you can melt them together with a material in between that makes them extra strong, give you some stability, and also if something breaks, it's going to basically adhere, glue together so it doesn't fall out of the glass or the opening. That can also be a really useful safety feature in a lot of applications. Some of the key properties of glass when you're looking at windows is the visible light, the heat that comes through, and those properties aren't necessarily related. You can actually vary those two toggle switches independently. So visible light transmittance, VLT, is how much of the bright visible light comes through. You might think of tinted glass as a way of controlling that glass, that glare, that light, that visible light coming through. Completely true. Tint will reduce the VLT, but it won't necessarily affect the amount of infrared. That's where we look at some of the low E coatings as being able to select out different wavelengths. So the solar heat gain coefficient, or the G value, they're sort of used interchangeably, mean very similar things. That's the percentage of the solar gain hitting the outside of the window that makes it through to the inside. That varies somewhere between zero, being an opaque wall, there's zero of that solar radiation coming through, all up to one would be an open air, no, nothing in between it, and somewhere in between is probably the right range. If you just had a piece of 3 mil clear glass, that's about 0.87, 0.89, somewhere in there. And if you get some of the more exotic low E coatings, you can get down to 0.2 if you're really trying to block the sun out. Up to, you know, 0.7 is also quite good. Anywhere in between could be the right answer for your particular building. You might hear people talk about shading coefficient. Shading coefficient is sort of is related to G value, but it is the proportion that solar heat gain coefficient has to clear glass. So you're comparing your piece of glass, your coating, to a piece of clear glass, And if the ratio is 0.87, 0.89, depending on how you want to calculate it. But it's really not a shading coefficient is not a useful metric to put into any energy model, really. So if someone's giving you a shading coefficient, you probably have to switch it to a G value to be useful anyways. So let's just all stop using shading coefficient. It sounds better. It's kind of a nicer term, but it actually is not that useful as a number. The coatings and the other variable to think about, so you've got the visible light, you've got the solar transmittance, and you've got the U or the R value. You can think about this like the convective aspect of the heat transfer. Also, independent variable of shading coefficient, or sort of G value, and independent of visible light. So those three toggle switches, you can toggle all those independently. They're not all perfectly related. So you can get glass that you can see through very clearly. There's almost no drop in light, but blocks a lot of the heat. And conversely, you can get something that blocks a lot of the light coming through, but still allows a lot of heat come through. So those independent variables can be important when you're selecting glass. Hopefully that's given you some ideas on what to look for when you're specifying glass. What are the key variables to look for? Just as a recap, your solar heat gain, your visible light, your U value, all pretty independent variables of each other, can be changed with low E coatings, relatively simple to apply to your project. Different types of glass, different types of IGUs, all those variables could be important to your building.
Give us a call. Or something like that, I don't know.